Pope Francis skipped reading his homily during the Palm Sunday Mass at St. Peter's Square at the last minute, but he continued presiding at the service. This is very unusual for a pope to totally skip a homily at a major event. The Vatican also gave no explanation. The pontiff, however, took time during the Mass to condemn what he called a vile attack in Moscow and offered prayers to the victims. The 87-year-old pope had been suffering from bronchitis and influenza in recent weeks. Ireland, set to have its youngest prime minister, 37-year-old Simon Harris, will assume the post following his unopposed election to succeed Leo Varadkar, who stepped down last week. Now, Harris served as Ireland's minister for higher education and the country's health minister from 2016 to 2020. He is best known for helping steer Ireland's initial response to COVID-19. Harris will officially be voted as prime minister when the Irish Parliament meets on April 9. Now, France raises its terror alert warning to its highest level following the shootings in Moscow. The French Prime Minister says the decision was taken in light of the Islamic State's claim of responsibility for the Moscow attack and the threats weighing on the country. The move comes months before Paris hosts the Olympic Games. The raising of the terror alert warning allows for exceptional security measures such as stepped-up patrols by the military in public places. Now, four of the suspects in the deadly Russia concert hall attack charged with terrorism. One of the suspects, a Tajikistan national, pleaded guilty to all charges. All four were ordered detained until May, pending trial. They risk a life sentence in prison. Friday night's attack, which killed 137 and wounded over 180 others, was the deadliest on Russian territory since 2004. 11 suspects were arrested. The Islamic State has claimed responsibility for the attack. Russia lowers flags to half-mast as it holds a day of national mourning for the victims of Friday's attack. People have been laying flowers outside the concert hall. Russian President Vladimir Putin also lit a candle in memory of the victims. Putin addressed the nation a day earlier and said the attackers had sought to escape towards Ukraine, with people on the Ukrainian side preparing to let them cross the border. Kyiv has repeatedly denied any role in the attack. President Volodymyr Zelensky also accusing Putin of trying to divert blame. More than 200,000 are left without stable power in Kharkiv following Russian strikes. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said these strikes were Moscow's biggest attack on Ukraine's power grid in over 2 years. Now, Russia pounded Ukrainian power facilities on Friday, striking a dam over the Dnipro River. The national grid operator said rotating power outages are also in force in Odessa following the strikes. In the Middle East, an Israeli airstrike hit Rafah early Sunday, killing 7 and wounding several others. Over 1 million Palestinians displaced by Israel's offensives are sheltering in Rafah, which is Gaza's southernmost town on the Egyptian border. But as Israel prepares for a ground invasion, civilians there say Rafah is no longer safe. The international community has warned Israel against an assault in Rafah. But Israel continues to justify its planned move, claiming Rafah is the last bastion, in fact, for Hamas. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres visited Rafah over the weekend. The visit by Guterres comes as Israel faces global pressure to allow more humanitarian aid into Gaza. He says the UN will continue to work with Egypt to streamline the flow of aid into the besieged enclave.
A long line of blocked red relief trucks on one side of the gates, the long shadow of starvation on the other. That is more than tragic. It is a moral outrage. Now more than ever, it is time for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire. It is time to silence the guns. Palestinians in Gaza, children, women, men, remain stuck in a non-stop nightmare. It is time for an ironclad commitment by Israel for total and unfettered access for humanitarian goods throughout Gaza. And in the Ramadan spirit of compassion, it is also time for the immediate release of all hostages.
Luzon's power grid at risk of falling under a yellow alert warning in the coming months due to the dry season worsened by the El Nino phenomenon. The Energy Department says though it is not expecting power outages, it remains on alert amid the expected scorching temperatures. The DOE urges the public to practice energy conservation. It also reminded power generation companies to comply with a DOE-approved operation and maintenance program to ensure they will meet target operational dates. The State Weather Bureau, PAGASA, on Friday announced the onset of the dry season in the country.
Ginawa nating mitigating measures. Pagdating doon sa ating mga power supply, kahit na sa testing and commissioning pa lang yung isang planta, yung mga committed projects na papasok ng first semester nitong 2024, binigyan na natin ng reminder na ang ating system operator na kailangan, kung kinakailangan itong mga planta na sa testing and commissioning, patakbuhin din para makapagbigay ng additional capacity. At the same time, tinawagan na natin yung ating mga distribution utilities, pati na rin ang NGCP, na magkaroon na sila ng alert para dun sa ating mga participants ng interruptible load program. So para maiwasan kagad natin na mayroong malakihang brownout.